We've been spending the past few weeks getting everything into our sessions. We've been composing, we've been creating, and now it's time to take another set of tools and start to refine what the sound is. And we're going to start by talking about audio effects processors. So an audio effect is a device which is going to take your audio signal and process it in some way by changing the sound. Examples of this would be reverb or delay, which are typically devices that everybody's heard or understands in some concept. But there's so much more under the surface. It's not just those devices that we already know about. And Ableton in particular has a lot of really creative effects inside of it. So I'm going to take a look at some of the ones that I think are really fun and that you might want to play with right away. But there's no way that we're going to be able to go through all of them inside of this short course. So after you watch this video, I want to encourage you to go through and check out everything that's there. Click on stuff, see what there is to see, and really explore the different possibilities with audio effects processing, because there's so much there. And I really want you to check it all out. So let's start by messing around with some of these tracks that we have. If I'm back in Live's browser over here on the left, I'm in the audio effects category. So you can see how many of these there are. I'm going to solo this hi-hat track. And what I want to do is create some stereo motion with the hi-hat. So I want them to pan left and pan right. So what I'm going to use is a device called AutoPan. So I'm just going to double click on it, and it will insert itself directly onto the track that I have selected, which is this hi-hat track. So I'll press play, and then I'm going to turn up the amount. And you can even see a visual representation of this wave going back and forth and back and forth. And we can hear that happening as well. So I also have the option of changing how fast it's going, or I can sync this to the BPM. You're going to see this a lot in a number of devices, that you can set something to a specific frequency, or you can set it to match the BPM. So now I have this moving in quarter notes. Okay, let's continue messing around. So I'm on this chords audio loop here. I'm just going to solo it so you can hear it again. And I'm going to add pedal. So this is an emulation of different guitar pedals, different overdrive pedals. So there's overdrive, distortion, and fuzz. I'm just going to click around and see what's going on. A little bit of crunch there. Very cool. And lastly, I'll just put some reverb on this sampler instrument. This is something we've probably all messed with before. Gonna just double click, put it on here, and we'll see what happens. Put some on this one as well. So before I add this next reverb, let's take a look at the different presets we have available to us. So every single one of these audio effects is going to have some pre-made presets for you to just pull on. And in Reverb's case, there are categories inside of those presets as well. There's halls, rooms, spaces, and even a special category. So I'm going to go into the room, and let's say this, we're going to put this in a garage. So I can just double click on this preset, and then here it is for me. Let's listen to this. So So in a matter of minutes, I've already kind of transformed the way the sound is by just checking out different effects, inserting them on, and messing with the parameters. You should definitely feel encouraged to twist all of the knobs, click all of the buttons. Worst comes to worst, you just delete it, add a new one, and continue to play. And if you don't know where to start, open a preset and load a preset directly onto a track.